Hey YouTubers, I'm Steve Piacenza.
And I'm Kathy Fillion.
And we just finished our Facebook Live, altering 21 candle ideas.
So we're sharing that video here with you guys. We've got so many different projects we're covering, as Steve said, 20 plus ideas for making adorable, cool holiday candles that you can give as gifts.
That's right.
You can decorate with them and you can sell them.
We also have dollar store candle makeovers. We have ideas for gift giving for pennies.
We've got projects using our Bad Santa photos, this cute little Christmas unicorn candle holder.
Yeah.
All these projects are using our favorite formula,
Mod Podge. So take a look. Hey everybody, welcome to Make It With Mod Podge Live. I'm Steve Piacenza.
And I'm Kathy Fillion. And today we have so much fun stuff to show you.
Yeah.
Now we all know that the holidays are right around the corner, and that means, well, for me, decorating, I think for most people.
Decorating for sure.
Gift giving,
mm-hmm.
Big gifts, little gifts, teacher gifts, all sorts of gifts,
yep,
right?
Absolutely.
And everybody wants to know, how can we do it ourselves? How can we do it on a budget? What can we do? So we've got a ton of ideas to share with you today.
Yeah, especially we're gonna be doing 20 plus ideas how to alter candles. Now everybody has candles in their home and candle ideas, but we're gonna show you 20 of them that are so simple to do and really kind of a pow.
Oh yeah, they all, and you know what's fun is we've got lots of different themes going on. So we've got some kind of boho Christmas, we got some vintagey looking Christmas, and we got some real traditional too.
Yeah, we got some paper, some pattern. You know what, Raphael, come on over here. Let's show, we'll give a quick little briefing. We have Raphael on camera today, everybody. So say hi to Raphael. Here it is. Here is our 20 plus altered candles, and we have everything from, starting with here at the beginning, we got some vase filler that we're gonna show you how to do. We have plain lanterns that we've turned into a boho look. We also have old photographs that we color copied and put them on top of candles. We have dollar store candles that we altered. We also have faux snow using salt, which is amazing. Again, more vase filler right here. We've got napkins that we're using. We have fabrics that we're doing, papers again, and then the little tea lights that we're gonna be altering all different ways with glitters and papers and little bits that we're putting on. We have some faux peppermints here using, what are we calling these, Kat?
Glass pebbles.
They're pebbles.
Yeah.
And then we also have family papers again here, more vase filler, and some bottle caps using vintage Christmas cards. So there is a lot to get to. I think we better get started so we're not here for 3 hours.
So before we get started, I do want to let you know that Raphael is here with us. So if you have any questions or comments, just leave them there. And if he can see them, sometimes we can see the questions and sometimes we can't when we're live. He will definitely shout them out to us and help you get those answered. If we don't see your question or don't get it answered, don't worry, because once we're finished here and Plaid gets the video permanently uploaded, so if you miss anything, don't worry, they will permanently upload the video. We will circle back and check on your questions because we will be moving pretty quickly through some of this stuff and we don't want to have any confusion. If you have questions, we want to make sure we get them answered for you.
Very good.
So, like we said, if you're just tuning in, we've got 20 plus candle makeovers. We're gonna start with our dollar store candle makeover. Now these candles, these are great candles for so many reasons. I actually have them in my earthquake kit. They're a safety candle. They burn for 7 days. So this is a really fun project. It's only a buck for the candle. Because if you're making this as a holiday gift and you give it at the beginning of the season, they can burn it the whole basically 25 days of Christmas.
Yeah.
And it'll probably last them the whole time. And then when it's over, it's over. But first, before you get started, what I have found is that you need to make sure your candle is very clean. I buy these plain. I've seen them in different colors. They even come in red. Some of them have labels on them, so you'll want to soak those labels off. And then wipe your candle down with an alcohol rub. Sometimes there's a little wax residue, and that is, your paper's not going to stick to that. I've gone ahead and pre-cut some scrapbook paper. And you can use any kind of paper. Wrapping paper, scrapbook paper, your own collage paper. I've cut it to size, so it's the height of my candle, and I have a little bit of wrap around there. You can see just a little bit. You don't need a very big lip. And I'm working with the gloss formula. You can use matte, satin, gloss, whatever you want. I don't know if you can see up here, Raphael. We've got the matte formula there and the satin formula. So the gloss is gonna give you a shiny look. The matte will be matte. and the satin is like kind of an in-between. So depending upon the look you want, that's, you know, the formula that you would use. So we're using gloss, and I like to go ahead and put a light coat on my glass. Just a little bit, not too thick, because we're gonna really saturate the paper. Now, all of the papers are a little different now because so many people manufacture with recycled papers. So if you have a paper you're not familiar with, sometimes doing a little tiny test on an old something recycled that you're gonna put in your recycle bin is a good idea. Go ahead and get that coated and set that aside. And then here's my paper. I like to start adding my Mod Podge on the back side because I'm gonna flip it and top coat this. And that way, if any of the paper peels up, it's not your image side. And you wanna really saturate it. We always say, make sure you get edge to edge.
So full coverage.
I start on the outside. And I'm just using a regular flat brush. You could use a foam brush. And then once I got it in the center, I go one more time around those edges. Then you're gonna flip it, and I like to work very quickly with this part because you don't want this to dry out. If it dries out, then that's where it's going to get bubbles. So you wanna have more than less. And get that smoothed out. Now quickly peel it up. Off of your paper, and then you're just going to line it up like so and start in the center there. Oh, it's already drying out. We've got hot lights. So if it's starting to dry out, just get it a little bit wet and wrap around, seal that edge, and then bring this one over just like so. And I like to pick it up and just kind of go like that to make sure you're getting rid of any air bubbles. What is this? Just the smooth, smoothing it out.
Making sure those air bubbles, you can push the air bubbles out. They move out really easily. And just smooth it out, feel it with your hands. I like to work with my hands and the brush at the same time, so.
So then once you think you have all your air bubbles out, you just smooth your brush strokes, because you don't want to have this. That's gonna not look good when it's dry. You want to have nice smooth brush strokes going all the way down. Then you'll just set it aside and let it dry. I am a sticky mess.
Yeah.
This is not the cleanest craft on the planet.
It's not supposed to be. There you go.
Thank you. And then when it's dry, you're going to get that nice sheen. So that's our candle. And then we just glued onto it one of these fun picks. And a little bow right down there.
It looks great.
And now it's perfect. So you can decorate your house with it, or it's a really good gift because it's just one little piece of scrapbook paper.
Yeah.
You can pick these up anywhere, but you could use anything. Scrap ribbon.
Well, there's so many different looks that you can do. Check this one out here. We also did with a plaid piece of paper here. And there's so many different elements you can put on these candles, which is great. You just want your base with the paper, which this one has plaid. And then we found this cool sticker, this reindeer sticker that we added right on top of it. We had these ornaments laying around. We glued those on and the little deer. And with the little roughage right around on the top and the bottom and a little piece of spruce right in there. So look at that compared to, I mean, you know, the differences that you can do with these, all three of them, you can make them completely different. And whatever your theme is for Christmas, you can really dial these in for that.
Well, and you know, so many people do like holiday bazaars where they're selling something or they're doing like at our preschool, well, the girls aren't in preschool anymore, but we still go back. They do a pancake breakfast, and they're always looking for table decor.
Easy. Well, this is,
you can get one big roll of wrapping paper and a bunch of these candles and make centerpieces for very inexpensive. Yeah. And if you get a big package of tinsel, you can use tinsel on it. So there's ways you could make this in multiples.
This one,
I wanted to just show real quick.
Yeah.
Another little tie-on is just a little candy cane like that. You know, you can really do them. This is sort of a theme for making cocoa. So that's, we went with the brown ribbon there.
Great.
But this would be really cute paired up with a couple of mugs and some cocoa packets.
And Christmas parties. I mean, you can, you know. Talk about inexpensive. Here's another really inexpensive way to alter a candle for the holidays, for a gift, for a party. which is this right here. And it's, you know, I'm gonna say this is my favorite all the, throughout this whole thing because I like them all. But this one is just a simple candle and the faux snow around it by using kosher salt right here. This is what we have and this is what we're using. So it's, let me show you how to do it because it's kind of, I think it's super impressive and really easy to do.
And what's cool about this is so many people decorate with like decorative candles that they're not even gonna burn.
Yeah.
So this is really fun if you get one of those strong scented candles and you can really decorate a mantle or a centerpiece.
So let's show you. You're just going to put your salt down. Come on out. There we go. You're just gonna add your salt down right on top of a piece of wax paper. You can use a paper plate, whatever you have. And then it's as simple as using your Mod Podge, taking your brush. As you can see with our design, we kind of went to make it look like maybe a snow drift. You can go straight across with this if you like, but of course that's
real modern.
Exactly, it can be really modern, or you can do it the way we did it, and you just kind of take your Mod Podge and make little waves to it so it looks like drifts of snow. Now you want a nice coverage of Mod Podge on this. You don't want it too thin because you want that salt to stick right on top of there, and you want it all different levels, and you're just really gonna go around and do some highs and lows. And again, this is a great gift for it's a great project for those kind of candles that have been laying around your house for a long time. If you want to do a little altering to them, this is a great way to do it.
Well, and I think this is a great kid's craft too.
Oh yeah.
Because kids can really do this, and this would be something fun that they could make to give as a gift. Yeah. And if you have an unscented candle, you can always add a few drops of essential oil to your salts, and then you could create a scented candle that way.
Okay, here's the magic now, ready? So now we're taking it, covered with the Mod Podge, and you're just going to simply roll it in your salt, and there it is. You can see it happening right before your eyes. You're just gonna go over it a couple times, and then I'm gonna take another dry brush, and I'm just going to take that off. Just the rest of it. Now what I like to do, there's two different ways you can do this. You can see some people enjoy having that red kind of show through, just like that. So if you feel this is, you know, how you like it, you can leave it. Otherwise, what you're gonna wanna do is you're gonna wanna let this dry. I would let it dry for about an hour. You're gonna add another coat of Mod Podge directly on top of your salt and then roll it again. So this one right here is two coats. So you can see it's a little bit thicker, more coverage. And then all we did is we added a nice little piece of ribbon and this silver snowflake right on top of it. And again, it makes a perfect gift, or great for parties, yeah, or mantles or whatever.
Yeah, it's a great little, because you know, not every candle do people burn.
Yeah.
So, you know, if you are gonna be burning a candle, obviously don't put the ribbons and things like that on it. But if you want something that you can make that you put out every year and it's more of a decoration, this is a really fun way to get a snowy look. Especially when you live in California, down here in SoCal, we don't have any snow. Nah. It's snowing at my parents' house though.
That's Chicago snowing too.
They sent me a picture, I was like, oh, I want snow.
Yeah, I'll be there soon enough, I'm happy.
So just a reminder, if you guys are just tuning in, we are doing 20 plus candle makeover ideas using Mod Podge, everything from fabric and paper to salts. If you missed anything from the beginning, don't worry, because the video will be archived at Plaid's Facebook page and probably on their YouTube as well. So you can always circle back and watch. And if you can't stick around for the whole video, just tune back in and you will be able to see the whole thing. Now I want to show you another idea with the salt. And this is just this cute Christmas unicorn candle holder. And this was done on a mason jar. And I think this is really sweet for a kid's room. Of course, if you're doing a kid's room, you will want to use a battery operated tea light in there, not a actual candle. What's different about this salt, I'm hoping you guys can really see how sparkly that is we used Mega Glitter, Mod Podge Mega Glitter, as a top coat. So we did the same thing as the red candle, coated it with the Mod Podge, rolled it in the salt, and then once it was dry, I top coated it with two coats of Mega Glitter. And Mega Glitter is our the glitteriest formula that we have. It's very thick. You can see how much glitter is in there. So that was just two coats of the Mega Glitter on there. And then We just made these holly leaf, these little felt ears. We went with holly. We, you know, obviously unicorns don't have holly ears.
It's a Christmas unicorn.
It's a Christmas unicorn. Yeah, of course. And these fun paper flowers just to top it off. Really fun gift, you know, for your kid's desk or whatever. So yeah. Sweet.
And kids can help out with this. It's fun for them.
Well, kids, I want it for myself.
Of course.
No, Delilah, it's mine.
Yeah.
So next we're going to show you this really sweet sort of vintage Santa look. And this started out as just a plain candle holder. Now this candle holder was $1.99, so very reasonable. And it holds a votive size candle. Mm-hmm. And we're working with fabric. So that's not paper, that's fabric on there. And that creates a really cool look. And we were talking when we were rehearsing, one of our things that we love about using fabric is that so many people sew for their home. So you might be sewing toss pillows, Christmas toss pillows, or placemats or whatever. And if you have scraps, this is, you know, just a very small amount of fabric that you need.
Yeah, and that's the thing. Everybody has scrap fabric laying around.
Yeah, or you can, you know, even just use a fat quarter or a quarter.
Yeah.
But, you know, if you did create some looks for your home, this is a fun way to create candles that match with it, because that would be hard. You wouldn't be able to. So we're using the fabric formula, and this is going to work fabric to fabric, and also fabric to other materials like glass and ceramic and stuff like that. It's a thicker formula. Oh, thanks, Steve. And what you're gonna do is start, well, I wanna show you. I cut my fabric bigger than I need. I want this row of Santas to be in the center of my candle, like that. So I cut it. This is going to get wasted. This is going to get cut off, but this will fold under. So you want a little bit to fold under and a little bit that you're going to cut off. I have to waste this part because I want this Santa right in the center there. So you start by, look how thick this formula is. That's not a regular Mod Podge, is it?
Yeah.
Cover your whole vase with a nice coat of the fabric Mod Podge. And you know, all of these instructions and pictures, we were saying earlier, they'll be at all the different social media channels.
Yeah, definitely. They're good. You can go to Instagram, you can go to kathyandsteve.com, or of course you can go to plaidonline.com and see all of this. And again, if you guys are just tuning in, don't worry, this video is archived, so you can go back. We did, earlier, we did some of the dollar store paper crafts. We also did the candle with the faux snow using salt, so you guys can check that back, but keep watching, and you can always go back and check it out.
So I have now coated the whole thing, and make sure you get that lip area. That's gonna be important, because we're gonna cut that fabric off. We want plenty up there. So once it's all coated, again, this is the fabric formula, not the regular formula. You look for it with the sort of turquoise blue label. I just wanna line it right up where I want my Santa to be. And you start to wrap it up, and then you'll smooth it as you go.
This is such a cool craft. You know what? Because this also, the fabric, and I think it might be hard to see, but the fabric looks and feels so different than the paper candles.
Yeah.
You know, it really gives it a...
almost is like silk screen.
Yeah, it gives it a completely different look. And when these are lit up with the candles, they're really beautiful through the fabric itself.
Oh yeah, nice glowing.
And what's great about it also, there's really great Christmas fabrics out
there.
So you, like you said, you get a little, what is it, a quarter there?
Uh-huh.
And get yourself a little bit and...
trim some of this
off. Yeah, you can really make some... some great gifts with fabric and Mod Podge.
And really, this is, I mean, we're talking about Christmas right now, but this works for any season and any home decor.
Yeah.
If you've got, you know, whatever your decor is. Then I just put a little bit there, and I'm gonna seal that over, just like so. And that will glue that down. Now at this point, if you wanted to create a shiny, shiny look, you would top coat the whole thing with the fabric Mod Podge. I don't want that look. I like this really matte look. I didn't want to go shiny. I'm going more with a kind of a vintage look. So what you're gonna do at this point, I'm not top coating. I'm gonna go ahead and cinch all my fabric around there. Then at the base, you just load it up. I hope you can see that good. Load it up, and then you just start folding it under, kind of like you would a present or something like that.
So easy.
And you just keep gluing it, just like so. Very, very, very simple.
Yeah.
Now, if you want to add like a little felt circle or something like that to the bottom, you can once it's all dried. And then at the top, normally I wait until this is totally dry, but I want to show you.
Since we're live,
I have to do it now. It's very simple. You just cut down to where you get to the glass, and then you just trim it. I can't even see what I'm doing, so I hope I'm doing a nice job for you.
It looks great.
You just trim it away. Now, you might get a few frays like that, and if you do, sorry, I'm blocking the camera there. I just run a little bit of Mod Podge on my finger, and that will seal that down.
Great.
And that's why you wanted to make sure you got enough of the Mod Podge there at the top. So I know that's a very quick tutorial for doing fabric, but I just want to show you what it looks like when it's done.
But it also shows you how quick these can be made.
Yeah.
You know, even doing it at a normal speed.
So this was just some scrap ribbon I had, some more of those little leaves from our unicorn, and a gem, but you can add ribbons, you can do whatever you want, you know, yeah. There's no rules.
Load them up, it's Christmas, right?
I just like to try to match to the fabric, but
yeah.
Come on,
well, we have, listen, you have, you've done a great job.
Oh, thanks.
So let's move on to the next. What we're doing next is we actually have three different ideas for vase fillers. So the first one we're gonna do is these marbles here. Now, as you can see, we put these marbles, gold marbles, into a wine glass with a little votive right there. It's a great, easy way to add some light to a Christmas table, to a mantle. Just, it's a wine glass, so it's a nice idea and really easy to do.
And you know what? It's not permanent. So if you had some wine glasses around or whatever, you're not Mod Podging anything to it.
Right.
This is, you know, you can just keep recycling these projects.
Here we go. These were just plain marbles that we got at the craft store. We've all seen them in the floral section, usually is where they're at. They're probably in a couple different places. And all we're doing is we are going to pour some Mod Podge. Show that label there. Always show that label. And we're gonna add Mod Podge right on top of it. It's all you need. And then I'm gonna use, you could use a spoon, a plastic spoon. I just have these little wood skewers. And you're going to just coat, move them around, just like so. This is so quick and easy and inexpensive, again, because some of this filler stuff is just, wow, it's so expensive out there. This is just an easy way to do it. And then we're gonna use gold. Again, you can use any color you like.
And that's ultra fine glitter.
This one is ultra fine, yes. You can do the chunky stuff too. You can experiment with it. This is the ultra fine, and we're just sprinkling some right on top. There we go. That's all we need. And then I'm gonna go and just move those around. Now you can also, you know, do a nice light coat, or you can do a heavier coat. Now you can, as you can see here, it still looks pretty white. You can see that gold in there on top, because this, the Mod Podge will dry clear, and then the beads will come out. So that's kind of the idea of where you can add glitter to these marbles and really get some great filler for, we're doing it a wine glass, you can also do it in any type of vases, you can do it inside floral arrangements, whatever you'd like, and it just adds a great extra, you know, again, I would say pow to whatever you're doing. Yeah. But
it's very pretty. I mean, it's just, it gives a little sparkle,
yeah,
and sheen.
And you can also do, you know, multicolors. You can do gold and silver together, which is really nice.
Yeah,
you can add some red to these, so they're very quick. And this will dry in about an hour, and there you have it. You have your filler, very easy filler to do.
I love these so much. The girls were
we have two more coming up, so stick around, because we're gonna be doing rocks, and then we're also gonna be doing kosher salt filler. Yeah.
So for the rocks, we did it the same way. We did the same way that Steve did the bowl here with the Mod Podge and the glitter. But what's different, I want to show you these rocks. They just look like big pieces of chunky ice or snow.
Yeah.
Very like a little melted snowman guy.
Yeah. They're really, really pretty.
So this started out as these white pebbles. And we got them at the floral department of the craft store, But I've seen different types of things like this, like an aquarium shops and stuff like that. And what we did that was really different from just using the plain gold glitter on the marbles is we used three different types of glitters. And I want to show you what those were like. This is found in the party section. And it's like this flake that usually people put in balloons. But it's really fun for, you can see what it looks like on our filler. It gives it that nice kind of chunky look on there. And then we also used ultra fine glitter. Oh, we're gonna be a mess today. There's glitter everywhere. We used some ultra fine glitter. And then we also used a chunkier glitter. And that's what creates that sort of 3D effect by having all those different sizes and shapes. But they're all white glitters with a little bit of a aurora borealis in it. So that gives it that kind of rainbow kick, makes it look like an icicle. So it's a really fun way if you want something. I tried and tried and tried. I wanted to do a cactus. Uh-huh. I wanted to make like a cactus candle kind of succulent Christmas look. Yeah. There's no cactus candles to be found. No. I couldn't find any. So imagine this to be a cactus candle. So it's a fun, you know, look if you want something kind of a little bit more earthy and deserty.
That's awesome.
Fake snow desert
fake snow.
Rocks.
It looks perfect. It looks great. And these are our last filler, which I, again, think is super cool. We put this in this hurricane here. And here's our, again, part of our boho Christmas here. But we used, this is kosher salt. This is kosher, I'm sorry. This is ice cream salt.
It's
kosher
chunkier.
Salt was the other one. This one's nice and chunky. Let's show that there. This is ice cream salt. The kosher was on the candle before. But as you can see, it's much thicker and chunkier. And I'm gonna show you just very quickly, we're gonna do a third installment of our three glitters. Now we use three different glitters for this to give it three different looks, because if you just use one, that's the look you're gonna get. But inside of this, you can see that it's a lighter, a little bit heavier, and then a deeper tone. And these are all different variations of purple lavender. And we just added straight in there, this is still a little bit wet right there, in there. And we're just gonna add a little bit more right on top. And you can see that it's already sticking to it. And then you just kind of play with it. You just kind of get the color that you want. So I'm just adding a little bit more. There is our second. And then we're gonna do our third. And you can see how shiny that really is. Now let's just add a little bit more. Right on top, look at that. And it really, really sparkles. Then you're gonna just add a little bit of Mod Podge. You can do it the opposite way. You can do the Mod Podge first. It really doesn't matter. It all ends up doing the same thing. You don't need too much because you want your dry time to be, you know, the more Mod Podge you put in, the longer it's gonna take to dry. Now, I like to put this out on an old baking sheet. You can stick it in the sun if the sun's out. Otherwise, you just kind of let it dry in your craft room or anywhere you want. And I like to let this dry overnight because
yeah,
it is salt.
Mix it up. I think also to keep it kind of maybe like halfway through the drying process, give it a little
stir.
Swirl so it doesn't clump too much.
Exactly, you kind of want to mix it up. Oh, there you go. There you have it. And there's kind of a nice little chunk piece that fell out there. And you can really see how sparkly that is. And again, as we know, ice cream salt is so inexpensive. You get your glitter. You all have glitter. And there's another way to do some filler. Pretty cheap and inexpensive. And you can fill these up in hurricanes. You can put them in, you know, little vases.
Yeah, any little votives.
Antique lights,
yeah.
Any antique lights, yeah. So that's our three.
Yeah, that's
so,
the three fillers.
So we have the ice cream salt, mm-hmm. We have the kosher salt. No, sorry. We have the ice
Don't
cream.
Don't forget about my rocks.
I know, and your rocks. Yeah. So there's our three. Perfect.
Now we're going to move on and show you this cool kind of boho stained glass look. And I don't know if you guys have seen it, but there's just so many holiday decorations with bright, bright colors this year. It's really, really fun. So we thought, you know what, let's do some projects that are really bright and bold and give this really simple globe vase from the dollar store a makeover. So we're using these confetti pieces. So this is large confetti, and it came in all these great jewel tones. This came as a mix pack, and you get it at a party supply or a party section of the craft store. Again, this is kind of like that white stuff. A lot of people, it might be with the balloons. A lot of people fill balloons with this. So when they pop them, it goes flying everywhere and creates a big giant mess. there's a few tricks to getting this to look so good. So I want to share those with you. And we're using the gloss formula. And one thing, this looks very, very glossy. I mean, we just kept saying, wow, how shiny it is.
Yeah.
And that's because you really do end up putting quite a few layers of the gloss on there.
It's so smooth.
Yeah, I know, right?
So great, yeah.
Well, that's because the
tissue
paper is so
thin. You just
want
to touch it.
Yeah. And we do have pictures of everything. We did not put candles in these projects today because we're moving so fast. But if you circle back to Plaid and our Handmade Happy Hour Facebook page, and on kathyandsteve.com, we will have the pictures of all these lit up so you can really see how absolutely gorgeous
this
they are.
This one's stunning lit up.
So you start with the plain base, and again, we cleaned it thoroughly, and we're using the gloss formula, and we're gonna start with the blue row first. That's gonna be important because you want to have a nice finished edge and you create that look after that. So you're gonna start with the blue, and I just wanna show you how simple that is. One thing to note is that I have found that most of these tissue paper dyes do spread. So you'll want to not be dipping into your Mod Podge jar unless you want to have blue Mod Podge. So pour it into a bowl, a work bowl, that you can not mess up all of your Mod Podge. So you'll start with the first layer by lining it up right along the bottom there, but not going over. And I got lucky, I just kind of put them right next to each other. Sometimes there's a tiny bit of an overlap, which is cool because that gives you like a little bit more deeper colors in some areas. And because it's so lightweight, it tends to move around. So it's more of a real gentle tap motion.
A little dabbing it on there.
Yeah, exactly. A little dab like that. And once it's kind of in position, then you can go over and smooth out. Whoops, see, got a live one. Move it over.
It's a runaway Christmas tissue.
So then you'll do that all the way around your candle, right? So next you can start by adding whatever color you choose next. So I like to go a little bit of an overlap then. See how I'm overlapping that? Very, very simple. And again, you kind of just tap it down and then always smooth out those brush strokes. First, I do this direction, and then once I got a whole row on, I would do up. And you really do end up doing so many layers. It's very, very thin layers of Mod Podge, but that's what's creating those, oh look, so you can see how the blue bleeds.
Mm-hmm.
So you really wanna, it doesn't make a difference over the confettis. It never altered the colors too much, but you wouldn't wanna dip that back in. Now, let's pretend like we've done the whole entire vase like that. I wanna show you how you do the bottom. So just pretend like we did all that, because that one took me quite a while to do. So you're gonna add your Mod Podge to the bottom. Go ahead and add it to that bottom layer. And then you will take whatever your bottom color is. Ours ended up being purple. And you overlap that piece. And I did it so that I was, whoops, wrong color. Going right over where the two left that hole. And then you'll just tap it gently, add a little bit to the bottom, and then just really gently bend them over like that. And then you'll do that all the way around and then just fill in the whole bottom like that. And if there's little holes in between, you kind of want a few of those because that's where the little light, you know, will pop through.
Mm-hmm. That's so pretty. It looks great.
And then to top it off, well, I should say, we let this dry, and I did have to do this in probably 3 or 4 stages, I can't remember. I would do kind of a row, and then it would just, I would have to let it dry before I moved on to the next row. And for the top, I just went over the edge just a tiny bit and sealed that down, and then I added just this really fun kind of ornate ribbon. And this goes in our sort of boho look.
A boho Christmas,
this
yeah.
This matches with the purple vase filler and the lantern that Steve's going to show you. So it's some bold and bright colors.
Yeah, we did kind of three boho pieces to show you guys. And this is a lantern. I'm sure you guys have seen it either at the craft store or the department store. They're all over the place.
IKEA has these too.
IKEA has them. So does Target and Walmart. I mean, they're everywhere and they're really popular right now. So we decided to take a plain one. The first thing we did was we added a little bit of gold paint and kind of brushed it over the whole entire thing just to give it more of a Christmas look. Brushed it over there, and then we added these little mini ornaments on top, and of course we topped it off here with a gold ribbon. But what I really wanted to show you is inside there's always a little door here, and as you can see, each one of these panels is from this piece of scrapbook paper here that we used, that we found it, and we thought the colors were great and they match what we were doing. So we did all these different panels, and they come out pretty easy. As you can see inside here, there's always these little lips here, and the panel comes right off. So what we want to show you, I just want to tell you really quickly that all the papers on the outside of the piece of the glass panels, not on the inside, because of course when you put a candle in here, you don't want it hitting the paper, you want it to hit the glass, so it's completely safe to light a candle in these things. And again, these things light up beautifully, but it's really simple. All we did was take the piece of glass out, and then of course we cut it, you know, to fit right on top of the glass.
And did you tell them, because I love how you cut around the paper to get all the different colors.
Yeah, there was, you know, we wanted definitely some of the pinks, some of the blues, and more of the purples. So we made sure that happened going all the way around. So you have all those colors happening. So it's not just one of the sections that's getting, you know, just that color. We made sure that all the colors were represented and displayed. And right on top of the glass, of course, Mod Podge works amazing with glass. And you're just gonna go right on top of your glass, hitting all areas. And then I like to go right on top, right on the bottom, on the clear side of that. And then put it right on top of the glass. And it really is that simple. So you're gonna put that in, and then I would usually wait about 10 minutes and then top coat it, but for, again, sake of time and sake of the live feed, you're gonna go right on top, and there you go. Once again, sake of time, I would let this dry completely, but I just wanna show you how easily these kind of put in. They just drop. This is the dangerous part about live. And then, I'm just gonna push these little things down right like that. And then shut the door, and there you have. There's your next piece right there. So you can see all the way around, and then of course we added a little gem right on top of that.
And we added a little bit of the sparkle Mod Podge too.
Yeah, let me just show you. We just added that right to, right on top. Where's my door? I lost my door. There it is. We went right on top of the snowflake. You just go right on top of it with the sparkle. I'm gonna show you in just a minute, but you can just highlight certain areas.
And coming up, I'm gonna be working with sparkle too, so we'll get another peek at it.
So you can see here in the light, see those snowflakes right there? See how they just add another little sparkle right on top. And of course, once that candle's in there, it really kind of pops and it looks beautiful. So yeah, so this is a great transformation, a plain lantern turn into kind of a boho Christmas. Of course, you can use completely different colors. You can do your traditional red and green on top of these lanterns, but it's just a great another way to transform something plain into something super Christmassy.
I can see this year round though, too. Yeah. You know?
Yeah. Really cool.
Very cute. Well, we wanted to talk about, so family photos. Everybody does some sort of Christmas picture, right? Whether you're just casual around the living room together, or you go and get Santa pictures, or you do a formal photo shoot for printed cards. So I think what's really kind of fun is to create some sort of lighting or gift that you can make using some of your family photos. And we are using this classic gem of Delilah and Sophia's first trip to meet Santa Claus. And you can see how thrilled they were It was a lovely evening.
Oh, so awesome.
And yeah, this was my like $30 souvenir from Santa Night, but it's pretty timeless. I mean, it's classic. So Sophia wasn't having any of it, and Delilah wasn't having any of it either. So that's why I want to create a family heirloom out of it.
It's so Delilah's face is priceless.
Yeah, she's
Sophia is, you know, your it's yeah. You know, they cry, but Delilah's like, what is she thinking?
Yeah.
She's like, I don't know about this guy. So funny. And she didn't cry.
No. She was not happy.
She was not happy.
She was like, I said to her, honey, there'll be presents at the end of this rainbow.
So fun.
So the same way we did the paper on our dollar candles, we did that the same way. But what I want to show you is, and we did not do the back. So normally I would put a piece of like holiday scrapbook paper here, but I wanted to be able to show you what kind of vase this was. So these are the tall vases, and Steve's going to be working with these with the napkin decoupage that's coming up.
Mm-hmm.
So these are in the vase department, in the floral department at the craft store, and they're pretty reasonably priced. So this is the same technique. Instead of gloss, I used the satin formula because I did not want that shine. I wanted it to be more of a matte look, but not too matte. So you get a little bit of a sheen, but not too much. And again, I do want to talk about photo. You want to get your family photos copied. Don't use real photos. It's not going to work. They're going to be too stiff and all that. So this is just from the copy shop. I did a color copy of it, and you can enlarge, blow up, whatever you need to do. But don't use real pictures. If you're going to do inkjet, test your inkjet first. Maybe spray it with a spray sealer. Some people use hairspray. I have not personally had great luck with my inkjetter printer, so either laser or color copy like this works the best.
Much safer with laser.
Because you don't want to get the smearing.
Yeah.
Some people have great luck, though, with their inkjet, so yeah. I don't know what brands, you know, so.
And again, don't use your originals because you don't want to lose them. No. You just want to copy them.
And don't leave them in the copier.
Yeah, that's a good point. I've done that before.
We did top it off with some velvet ribbon just for Santa's, you know, Santa's suit, I guess, to match his suit. But this is a fun gift if you want to send something to grandparents or whatever. It's just another way you can use your family
photos. Great. Cost effective. But again, you know what? We talk a lot about, you know, pricing and inexpensive and all that, which is great and stuff. But sometimes, like on a kind of present like this, I wanted to give it to my sister. So here's my sister. Me and my sister back in
1947.
1922, as you can see. Come on. That was pretty cute, wasn't
you were
I?
Cute.
I was
he cute. Feels pretty cute too.
So what I did was I went and got an expensive candle because this is a Christmas gift and my sister loves candles. She loves to burn candles. She actually burns them all year round. So I got her a nice Christmas candle. It smells really nice, doesn't it?
Oh yeah.
So it's kind of an expensive candle.
I'll take an expensive candle.
But what a way to personalize it again with an old photocopy. And I don't think she's seen this picture in years.
Well, she's watching now.
Well, now if she's watching, I'm not sure if she is, but she'll be surprised because I've had this picture of us. I mean, it's got to be for, I've had it personally for like 30 years.
Yeah.
So she's going to be surprised seeing this picture.
So cool.
And it's on a really nice candle. So this is another way to do a gift with using personalizing it with a really personal picture and on top of, you know, a nice candle. Ooh, yes.
Yes.
Here we go. Okay, let's.
So I'm napkins. Sure y'all know two things are very popular this holiday.
Napkins are one of them.
Napkin decoupage and buffalo check. Here's your buffalo check down in there.
Mm-hmm.
We've got kind of a red, black, and white theme going on. And one thing that, well, I don't know if you guys are members of the Mod Podge Facebook group. Not just Plaid's page, but the Facebook group. There's so many fun ideas for napkins on there. So every time we log on there, we're just getting in, seeing more and more inspiration and fun things that you can do.
Yeah.
I guess the real thrill of it is hunting for napkins, you know, trying to find these napkins.
And that's what's brilliant about it too, because like fabric, I mean, there are so many cool napkins out there right now. There's some great Christmas napkins and, you know, like we said earlier, it's not just for Christmas. You can do this, you know, with Mod Podge throughout the year.
So before we get started, can we talk about table coordination?
Yes.
Because I'm the girl that likes to have everything match. He likes it to be more mismatched. I mean,
yeah, I like a little bit mismatched, but
like,
you know.
So in my head, I'm like, okay, you're gonna have a dinner party or you're having lots of guests over. So let's say this is the napkins that you've chosen for your event. What I think is so fun about this is you've got these napkins out, and can you imagine if your centerpiece really does truly match your napkins? Same kind of deal as with the fabric. You know, if you had Santa pillows like this and then you had candles that match, you can create a super coordinated look very quickly just with paper napkins.
It's impressive.
And people fun. Are like, I love it.
How did you do that? How did you find?
I'm so hooked on napkin decor.
How did you find the candle holders to match the napkins?
We DIY'd it. Well,
so you just take a plain old napkin like this. There it is.
Right? Non-used.
Non-used. And again, I cut it to size to fit our hurricanes. But you want, these are usually either 2-ply or 3-ply. This is a 2-ply. And you want to separate.
This is the hardest part.
Very important, yeah. You want to separate it like that so you get the 1-ply. And this you can either throw away or figure out something to make with it, right?
I use these as little wipes.
I don't. next thing you want to do is you want to match up. I like to start at the bottom. So I like to get my napkin, bottom of my napkin, and match it up with the bottom of your cylinder hurricane vase, just like that. So the first thing that I do is I work in little sections because that's the best way. This is, napkins are really, really delicate. So you gotta be really kind of careful to work slowly.
Especially if you have a striped pattern like that. If you have an all over pattern, it's not quite as difficult.
Yeah, it's a little bit more forgiving. But I like to put a strip down. You wanna make sure you get from top to bottom. And that's all I like to do first. And then slowly, I like to match the bottom of the napkin with the bottom of the cylinder. Now, this is the part that you want to just really work slowly and make sure you match it up. You getting that, Raphael? Just like so. Then immediately, what I like to do is I like to shimmy it just a little bit, like so, because what you're going to do is we put ribbon on the bottom and top if there's any little imperfections. So you can see when I'm gonna be working around, it's gonna match up to the bottom. Because if you were off a little bit, this bottom part would go on an angle, and that's what you kinda don't want. So now that I have my top piece down, let me get a little bit more underneath there just to seal it, and then I immediately just like to seal that down just like that. Now, I don't put any Mod Podge on the top right now. I just like to tap it down with my fingers and just make sure any little wrinkles or bubbles are pushed down. And with napkins, they go down really easy. Even the little bit of the wrinkles kind of work into what you're doing and you can't really see them. So
and
now,
I would say with napkin decoupage, there's the people who say a little wrinkle is fine.
Yeah,
and then there's
sure.
the people that say they don't want any wrinkles.
Right.
So if you don't want any wrinkles, you can apply a piece of Saran Wrap over there and really work them out. For this look, we're going for it with a little bit of the wrinkles just to keep that sort of rustic look. I think it's, I like it.
I like the wrinkles too, but it's not, I mean, even so, I mean, there's barely any. I mean, there's a little tiny one there, but that kind of adds to the charm and the look. So then you flip it over and go really close with your brush right on in there. I like to go as close as I can to where the other Mod Podge is hitting the cylinder. You want to match those up. And again, I like to do about an inch at a time, inch and a half, and then flip it back over, pull it a little bit tight. Again, push it down with your fingers. I know I'm working upside down, you guys, but I usually work with my right hand instead of my left, otherwise I'd be in trouble. And then again, you just keep going all the way around. Let me do one more for you guys, and then you get the idea. Again, get very close, right on in there. Then about an inch, inch and a half. You don't want too much Mod Podge on there. You don't want to saturate it. A nice thin layer works great. Flip it, pull it a little bit, and then with your fingers, just go all the way around. So that's kind of the key for me. The key works out that I just do an inch and a half at a time and work all the way around. And you can see I'm pretty good on the bottom here. Don't worry if it's not, you know, super, super perfect. You can add a piece of ribbon around that or any type of, you know, different embellishments, but we're pretty good on this one.
Yeah, and once you have it all in a centerpiece, really any of those little imperfections are gonna disappear.
Yeah, what's great about it, if you did make a mistake, you know what, you can just wash it right off and start over again. It's a little frustrating until you get the hang of it, but once you get the hang of it, it's pretty easy to do. And again, napkins come in so many different variations and colors and patterns, and we just saw these deers and we thought it would work perfectly. So we did two different sizes. We have the two on the end here and the taller one here. And we just added some black ribbon around to coordinate with our wood plaque down there.
Yeah, so this wood plaque, do we want to show them how you just chop off the top real quick?
Oh, we can, sure.
Yeah,
okay.
I think that's important.
Okay. Yeah, so let's just say this was all Mod Podged all the way around. It's really simple, guys. All you're gonna do is, let me just start it. You're just going to go around with your scissors, and you can just get, what I like to do first is just get a nice little layer off first, so it's not, so you're working with something a little bit easier. And then I like to go back and go right in there really closely.
And you kind of have to go around like two or three times until it gets really flush with the glass.
And it looks probably more difficult than it actually is because your scissors really kind of stop right where the edge of the napkin is and where the glass cylinder top is. So you can see, of course I'm doing this really quick for you guys, but you can see how it's kind of a nice edge. And then I like to take a little Mod Podge with my finger, and I like to just go around that edge like so, and you're just gonna seal that down. You know? And go around it a couple times. Just make sure you got these little bits and pieces off. But there we go.
So cool.
Voila!
It's so simple.
Napkins.
So now, yes, and also in that Mod Podge Rocks Facebook group that I was telling you about, there are people who are even doing napkin swaps and stuff. Mm-hmm. So it's a really fun community where you can go and see what other people are making and get some inspiration for napkin projects.
Are there any questions, Rafael?
No, just people asking what type of Mod Podge. I've been good at showing them the labels of all the different ones you guys have been using.
So for most of these projects today, we're using the basic gloss formula because that's a formula that, you know, most people have or have really ready access to. Some of the other specialty formulas that we used were fabric, when we did the fabric vase, like this.
And of course we have satin again. Now this is, these mod, the gloss, the satin, and the matte are the same Mod Podge, they just have different looks. Of course the matte has a much more matte, the satin is in between a matte and a gloss,
and
the gloss
is glossy. Here.
Yeah.
Satin was on the picture, so it gives a little bit of sheen, but not too shiny.
We also used.
And would that work with tissue paper or is
Yes, any of the basic formulas work with tissue paper, but on this one we used the gloss because we wanted that really kind of shiny. We wanted it to look like stained glass.
But all the formulas work on tissue paper, if that's what the question is, yes.
And we also used the Mega Glitter on our unicorn here. So this was our mason jar that was coated in the rock the kosher salt, and then we top coated it with Mega Glitter, and this is in the hologram. That's why you're getting all those really pretty rainbow sparkles in there. And then the other formula that we're using today is sparkle, and the sparkle formula is very glittery, but different than Mega Glitter. It's got really fine. This is one of our bottle projects that's coming up, and it's got both formulas. It's got, this is our Mega Glitter here, and then if you look on the image, that's the sparkle. So I don't know if you can see that, but we're gonna show you how you apply the sparkle Mod Podge just to add little tiny details. It's one of my favorite formulas. Even on the girls' birthday cards that they might be giving to a friend or something, I go in on a store-bought card and I add a little bit of sparkle Mod Podge just to give it a little zhuzh.
A little zhuzh. Like I like to say, a little pow. You're the zhuzh on the pow.
I gotta turn the lights on. This is coming up.
Oh, don't show them that yet. Alright. Hey, if any of you guys are just tuning in now, this is archived, so you haven't, you can go back and watch everything. You haven't
once we're done. It takes Platt a little, maybe 20 minutes or so, but they'll upload it to their Facebook page, so you can see the beginning if you miss anything, and you can certainly see what we're doing if you have to skedaddle.
Alright.
So now, this time of year, for me, is like mini gift insanity. We've got everyone from our neighbors,
teachers,
the ladies who helped me with the car drop-off at Sophia's school, because she's still in the harness, so they have to come and like get her out. So I always try to give like a little something to all those people throughout the year who helped me out. So we were thinking, let's come up with some fun mini gift ideas that are candles.
That's not going to break the bank.
Yeah, inexpensive, and they're not candy. Everybody's getting candy, you know, and that kind of thing. So this is just a plain votive that came filled. And we are creating this cute little Santa look. So this idea was that maybe you give a gift set of three of these candles. Now these were a dollar a piece. Actually, they were 99 cents for two, so they were 50 cents a piece. And these were just papers that I already had. So, you know, lots of people have extra little bits of holiday papers and stuff like that. Again, you can use wrapping paper, you can use magazine cutouts, whatever. One thing I do want to say about this is that unlike the vase, the napkin vase is really pretty straight up and down. These are not. It looks deceiving because you think it's straight up and down. And if you were to cut a rectangle piece of paper and try to wrap it around this, you would not be successful.
I guess just check, because some of them are straight up and down, but some of them do have that slight.
It's very slight.
And that you're going to get into trouble if.
Almost all of them have the slight. It's just how they make them. So I like to create a paper template first. And this makes it go a lot faster when you're cutting out your decorative paper. So you start by taping on a larger piece of paper and you wrap it around and then you tape it together. And then you'll just cut around to create a pattern. So you want to create a pattern of what your candle holder is before you do it from your decorative paper. And then you just cut it out of your decorative paper, and you can see that we have a decorative little motif that we cut out of scrapbook paper too. And it's so simple. This one, because it's a small project, I don't really need to coat my glass like we did on the dollar store candles at the beginning. So you can just add your Mod Podge to the back of your decorative paper. And I'm not top coating the paper either because it is smaller. So I don't need to keep it as wet, just like that, and then wrap it around. I kind of start in the middle and you just kind of shimmy it. That's how quickly, just kind of, you can move it around into position, overlap it, and you just keep moving it till it gets right where you need it. I mean, it's really that fast to do it. And then for your motif, same deal. It's almost like you're just applying a sticker, but you just put that right on the back. I want to find where your seam side is, go right across from that seam side. Just like so, push that down. If you wanted to do a monogram or something like that, you could do a person's initials. You could even do a little tiny photo, whatever you want to do. But there's so many different papers out there.
Mm-hmm.
Smooth that down. This is a very popular wedding craft. People do these for weddings a lot.
Get an assembly line together, you know?
Get the whole neighborhood over.
Yes.
Just top coat. And then I would top coat all the way around it. And once it's done and dried, what we did was we just added, you know, a little bit of our Mod Podge to the edge. And then we just sprinkled glitter on there and added a little scrapbooking embellishment. But it's a great little set of three, you know? Very inexpensive to make this candle gift.
Again, it just brings them to life.
Oh yeah. Now we have a couple other quick candle things we want to show you, and that is these battery operated tea lights. This is a very quick, same way we did that glittering there. These are just stars like this, plain. And of course they're cute on their own, but I'll show you really quickly how we added that glitter border. Same deal, you could do all over, or you could just do the edge like we did, because we kind of wanted to keep that shiny silver topper. And then you just sprinkle glitter on it. I mean, it's really that easy. But it gives an extra little thing.
Yeah.
And then you could do a set. This one we did all over glitter. And then the red one, we just did the border as well. So this is an ultra fine glitter. Whoop, we lost a little light. And this is the chunky glitter.
Do you remember last year when we had these on the table and they were like, where did you buy those at?
Yeah.
Thanks, well,
we did them.
We did it. We made them.
So there's those. And then one other little tiny quick gift idea that I think is really, really cute are these little candle bags. And these are tea lights that have been covered with washi tape and Mod Podge. So if you're looking for a little gift, just a little baggie of three is sweet for someone, or a package tie-on, or you could do a bigger set like this. And these candles are tea lights, but they came with the clear outer edge, which I thought was so pretty. Just a little bit of a step up from those silver ones. And we have washi tape. Let's see if we can get it started. My poor hands are covered in Mod Podge, as usual. So it's really as simple as, let's see if I can get that to balance, adding the washi tape all the way around. I would normally use a scissor, but I'm just gonna go ahead and tear that. And look how cute that is. Now the problem, I have such a love with washi tape, but so many things it doesn't really want to stick to. So what I do is I put that on there and then I top coat it with the gloss Mod Podge. Now you could also use one of the glitter formulas if you wanted to add more sparkle, but you just go around and you top coat it and that will seal all that washi tape down. So then you can have these cute little washi covered candles. And again, stack them up in three,
put them in a baggie,
put them in a bigger baggie, give more. This is really fun. You know, everybody needs a tea light at the holidays.
Yes.
So again, different than having to give chocolates or something like that.
It's a great alternative. Perfect.
Especially since I need like 20 mini gifts.
Well, that's it. It's perfect for, like you said, so many different people. Yeah. Well, we had a lot of like scraps laying around, as I think everybody does when they're crafting. You know, little sections of papers, and so we decided to, on top of another candle, just use our little bits and pieces. So underneath here on this plaid was from our dollar store candle, and this little top piece that we cut out was from a section of our dollar store candle also. So we just kind of matched those two together, and we Mod Podged them together, layered them up, and then added a little bit of chunky glitter right on top of that, added a bow, added some little embellishments right there. And again, we can't say it enough. It just, boom, it takes a plain old candle and turns it into something pretty special for a gift.
And if you wanted to do, you know, the monogram or something to really personalize it, you could do someone's, you know, last initial or something like that. Yeah. But it's a great way to just quickly alter a jar candle.
Talk about altering. We can alter the outside of these plain candle holders. Let me show you this right here. We did it just with beads and Mod Podge. So here's another little trick that you can do. If you have these laying around, or you know, go out and buy a couple of them, they're inexpensive. I've got about 50 of these in one drawer at home, and they all kind of look the same, different sizes, but this is a great way to alter that. And you can just stick a candle in, a festive color, whatever you want. Let me show you very quickly. I'm gonna do one side of this. I've got some beads here. Of course, we're using gold, but you can use any kind of beads that you want. You
can use a seed bead.
That's a seed bead.
With a hole. Now, you could also use the holeless beads.
Yeah, any kind of bead you want. And you can do them at any level. We wanted to do them to where the candle would kind of peek through. And you just want to put in a straight line. A lot of people like to tape it to get that really sharp line. I'm more of a organic kind of guy. And you want to layer that up with Mod Podge, so it's not a thin layer.
And this is gloss.
It's a little chunkier. It's gloss, and of course you could do this with matte also. Matte works. And then you're just going to take your, you're going to do all four sides. I'm just going to do one side though, because it's the same thing, just to show you guys. You're just going to drop that in, and then I like to take them and sprinkle them on top. Now this is another one of those that you want a little bit of dry time.
you're going to do one layer. You're gonna set this aside and let it dry for about an hour. And then you're going to directly put your Mod Podge right on top of your dried beads and do a second layer. And just load it up and add it on top. And of course, the Mod Podge dries clear, so all you're gonna see is beads. So that's it, and you're gonna work all the way around. You're gonna let that dry and then add your Mod Podge. And here it is, all the way around. It's pretty cool.
It's such a, I love it. It's got so much texture to it.
Yeah, again, these are great for tabletops. This is great for on top of your mantle.
It's good for me.
It's good for you. You can have this one. And again, a nice gift. You can put this in some wrapping, a little bow, and
yeah, so voila. Easy. And a lot of people have what everyone calls bead soup. Mm. So they have a lot of seed beads or little tiny beads that have, you know, collected in a bowl or something like that. So you could do this great multi-colored look if you want to. I mean, it's really endless as far as the other ideas. There's a lot of little tiny crystal. They're not real crystal. They're like shiny glass.
Yeah.
Those are really pretty too. We did that last year on an Easter thing, and that really turned out beautiful. It has a lot of sparkle. So this is our faux candy cane peppermint candy
Yay.
Base.
This one's my favorite.
Again, we do not have the flame on, but because we're just trying to be safe in here. But we will have the pictures of this lit up, and it's so beautiful. The light just comes out from everywhere. And these are, everybody knows them, the glass flat pebbles. So very easy to find. Every craft store has them. And normally, if you're doing like, a lot of people do map, you know, or specific images, and you would put your glass piece down and trace around it because you're lining up a specific image. With this project, you don't need to do that. So it goes a lot quicker than if you were doing more of a designated image. So I just want to show you how quick that is. This is the gloss formula again. And the gloss one is our beginning bright orange label right there. The very first Mod Podge. So you just add your Mod Podge. I'm using a round brush here because I like to kind of get a lot on there. And then you'll just put it anywhere on the paper. Just push it down, kind of get any of those air bubbles out. And then let it dry, just like that. So it's a lot faster than having to trace, because each one of these glass pebbles is a completely different shape. They're all different. They're not perfect. So once you've done that, uh-oh, my scissors are missing. Stevie, did you steal the scissors?
Oh, no, let's see.
Here they are.
There we go.
I only have 120 pairs of scissors, but these are the ones I need. So once it's dry, and that takes about 2 hours to dry, I did cut them out and then I flipped them over for another about half hour to let the paper on the backside really dry up. Then you just go around it, and you can see how easy now to cut it out. And you just cut off that excess paper. And that's really how quick, whoop, I got a little, I like it to be perfect, there we go. You can see how quick you can do that just by not having to trace around and stuff. And then we used a heavy duty glue and we just glued them down to this square vase. Now you can use this for tea lights. It's also really pretty. I know we're talking about candles, but there's no reason why this isn't perfect for floral arrangement too.
Definitely.
You could do a series of them and you could do some with candles and some with flowers,
yeah.
You know. But this candy cane paper, it was 29 cents. For a giant piece. So this project really only costs about $4.
Yeah,
and at the most.
Yeah, it's such a huge transformation. from just the plain old glass vase.
Yes, and I do hope you guys take a chance to look at the pictures of everything lit up. They should all be probably posted by the end of the day today, but they do look stunning with the lights flickering through.
Well, speaking of a plain glass vase, what about a plain bottle here? We transformed this plain bottle into this. And very simply, by using some Sparkle Mod Podge, this is the one that we used. What's that?
This is the Mega Glitter.
Oh, that's the Mega Glitter. We used Sparkle on this, didn't we?
Well, Mega Glitter's on the outside, and then Sparkle on the card.
Oh.
I was like, wait a minute, she switched it up on me. Okay, yes, that's what happened. She confused me for a minute.
Sorry, guys.
Sparkle on the outside.
I like all the glitters. I want to use them all.
And let me just show you really quickly how it's done. So the mega glitter.
And this works on any old recycled bottle. You can also pick these up at the craft store.
Oh yeah, this is so great.
But bottle crafts are so popular
right now. It's so popular. As you can see, I just like to work it down like so. And again, this is gonna take about three different layers, three different coats to get to achieve this look. And again,
it depends. Yeah, this one's frosted.
Yeah, this one's frosted, but again, you can kind of see the stages and stop wherever you'd like. Because this one has like just a nice little hint of kind of the sparkle in it. But the more layers you put on, the more frosted it's gonna get and the more sparkly it's gonna get. So that's kind of the way it looks right now. And this is gonna be dry, completely clear, and just the sparkle's gonna come out.
This is
three layers right on top of that one.
That's the Mega Glitter. You can see the different sizes. What really sets Mega Glitter apart is that it's got tiny, tiny bits of glitter. I hope you guys can see that. And it's got bigger flakes, and that's all the hologram, Aurora Borealis.
Beautiful.
So it kicks up really shiny rainbow. I mean, it looks like beautiful icicles, which was our whole intention.
And then what we did, we just took a vintage Christmas card, and we photocopied it and Mod Podged it right on top of the bottle. And then we added the sparkle formula. And we just highlighted certain areas. So right here you can see on the Christmas trees, right next to Frosty there on this Christmas tree. So it just kind of bumps that up. And then we added a little bit of trim right here at the neck of it and finished it off with some rhinestones on each corner.
And one of the reasons why we used a photocopy of the greeting card is that they are almost too stiff. So if you're trying to go around, if you were doing it to a flat object, you would probably have good success. But if you're trying to do something that's heavier paper around a bottle, it's going to be a little bit trickier. So a color copy or a laser scan is really the way to go.
And you've all seen everybody's seen these at the store, I'm sure. These are a light that are on a little bit of a wire here. And at the top of it, it's a faux cork. And you just drop it right in the bottle, and then you turn on the light. And look at that. That's so really sweet. Pretty. This is great, again, for so many different places. And again, a great gift and great for the home for the holidays.
And some people are still preparing for their holiday bazaars.
Yes.
So even though we've talked about all of these projects being great gifts and being great home decor items, They are also really good things to sell. So if your school or your church or your organization is having a holiday bazaar this year, you may not be, have enough time for it, but things like these little tea light bags and these, I don't know where the other votives went.
Also the dollar stores.
All of those make really great fundraising and bazaar items. You can get a couple friends together and bang out a bunch of projects and have all different holiday looks.
Yeah, so there it is, our 20 plus altering candies. You want to take another quick Raphael in there and you guys can see. And again, guys, if you are just tuning in, this is gonna be archived so you can see everything you're seeing right now created and give you inspiration on how to alter candles for the holidays. So everything from fillers to faux snow.
And if you have any questions, be sure to leave them here. I know we didn't answer very many live, but we will circle back and we will be sure to answer all your questions that you might have.
All right. Well, thanks for joining us, everybody. That was fun.
Make sure you follow Plaid social channels, Instagram, Plaid Crafts on Facebook, plaidonline.com is their website where you can pick up all the supplies that you need and get lots of inspiration from us and the team at Plaid and the Plaid creators. We're Kathy and Steve. You can find us at Facebook at handmadehappyhour.com or on our website at kathyandsteve.com.
And happy holidays to everyone.
We'll see you next time.
See ya.